We use cows for milk, fertilizer, and food. But the truth is, cows use us for much more than that. Truth. The Alu Munati, a deadly dairy dictatorship. How is it that 35,507,500 cows are slaughtered in the United States each year, but less than 1% of costs accrued by the meat industry goes towards blades, cap bolt guns, and other tools commonly used to kill cows? Is it possible that the secret sect of the cow elite is manipulating us to benefit the bovine masses? 260 million acres of land in the United States is allotted to growing grain for consumption by sheep, pigs, and cows. Sheep, pigs, and cows. Where's the beef? There's the beef. That's enough land and food to fully support all of the world's cows for 20 years. The average life expectancy of a dairy cow in the United States is 20 years. Other truths. President Roosevelt's New Deal. More like President Roosevelt's Moo Deal. In 1933, President Franklin Delano Roosevelt passed the Agricultural Adjustment Act, establishing a federally funded subsidy system for farmers. It single-handedly created the resource-heavy cattle paradise that American cows live in today. How did this bill get passed? Let's look at the facts. Pauline Wayne was the last known cow to hold political office in the U.S. From 1910 to 1913, Pauline freely grazed on the White House lawn, had daily access to then-President William Howard Taft, and provided milk for the Taft family in her official capacity as White House pet. Her closest confidant and later leader of the conservative coalition, President Taft's son, Senator Robert Alfonso Taft. The very same Robert Alfonso Taft that didn't stop Roosevelt's New Deal. Final truth, Robert Alfonso Taft loved milk. Subscribe below and let me know in the comments what animal you'd like me to uncover next. Was a CIA operative really Deep Throat, or was Deep Throat most likely a giraffe? Tell the world. The revolution will be telling me out.